on 2K Sports. We're ready to bring the year to a close in style. Hi, folks. Brian Anderson here, alongside two fantastic analysts, Grant Hill and Brent Berry at the table, and our reporter, Allie LaForce. Allie, take it away.
Well, guys, the Thunder may be in a rebuild, but the finished product could be special. They've got a lot of picks in the coming years, and they have shown a knack in the draft. In fact, after praising their number six pick, Josh Giddey, LeBron James labeled OKC's front office as their, quote, real MVP, praising their eye for talent. Brian?
All right, Allie, thank you. Now a look at Philadelphia's starting lineup. Up front, it's Tucker at the four, next to Embiid in the middle. D'Anthony Melton out there with James Harden. And it's House in at the small forward position. And for the Thunder, tandem at the one and the two, it's Giddey and Gilgeous-Alexander. Holmgren is out there with Alexei Pokuševski. And it's Williams in at the three, the small forward. Well, whenever you bring up the 76ers, you instantly think of Joel Embiid.
Oh, no question. He's the face of this franchise. Embiid is as good as anyone in the league. Off the floor, Joel is willing to take the blame when things don't go right. That's who you want as a leader.
Now, here's Williams. Pass to Gilgeous-Alexander. Shoots over Harden. And Gilgeous-Alexander missing. Outside Harden. Got it. Good job in the low post.
Harden just loves scoring through contact. He seeks it out while trying to get fouls on his shooting attempts.
Outside, Williams. And too long on the shot. Melton against Giddey. Pass to House. Back to Melton. Jacks up a three. And Harden gets it to go on the assist from Melton. Harden's got five.
Just strong awareness from Harden on the catch and shoot. He knew exactly how much time he had.
Here's Giddey. In his last outing, 16 points for him. And here's Gilgeous-Alexander. Back to Giddey. Here's Holmgren. Embiid covers. Now here's Gilgeous-Alexander. Just five on the clock. Giddey finds Gilgeous-Alexander. There's the triple. Again, no good by Oklahoma City.
It's hard not to want payback when you give up a three at the other end, but it can force you to rush things.
Harden against Giddey. Pass to House. From deep, Melton. And the rebound goes to the Thunder. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Hornets.
And games like that are backbreakers. To be so close to victory but let it slip away is frustrating.
And you want to respond in kind, but that last game, it was an effort that most of the time can get you a win. You ran into a tough opponent who was playing at a high level.
Here's Harden. The Thunder making their last shot. Pass to Embiid. Embiid drawing the double team. Here's the three. Harden misses. The Thunder have gone 1-4 to begin this one. Williams on the wing. Here's Holmgren. From deep three-point range. That one no good. The 76ers go the other way with it. Their first chance this season playing the Thunder.
They should have steamrolled this club last year, but that's not how it played out.
And Tucker gets it to go.
A little contact is not going to do enough against a guy like PJ Tucker.
About 3 minutes gone in the first quarter. They need something good to happen here.
Yeah, they've gone way too long without a score.
Harden against Gilgeous-Alexander. Offensive board. Pokuševski. Nice work on the boards, paying off with a basket.
That's an easy board for Poku and an easy putback.
The Sixers leading. And we're approaching about 3.5 minutes played in this first quarter. Pass to House. And here's Tucker. got a piece of it, and they get it back.
And Poku really outsmarting the opposition that time defensively in the right spot.
And it's time to take another look at that powerful block.
I mean, letting them know up front that he's on the hunt tonight and eager to knock away shots. I love it.
For Oklahoma City, they've gone 2-for-7. A sluggish start. Here's Williams. Outside Giddey. Back to Gilgeous-Alexander. Outside Williams. It's Giddey on the wing. Back to Williams. Shot clock at 6. Fires at the elbow. That one's wide left.
Now that's just enough defensive pressure on him to throw off that shot. I bet he gets a good look at it next time and hits it.
Melton against Giddey. Here's Tucker. No good on the 3. That's tipped and stolen by Melton. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair. That one on Giddey.
He can be such a physical force. It's so hard to keep Embiid from getting to the free throw line.
Shooting 2.
First free throw is good.
And last season's scoring champion, Joel Embiid, the first center to lead the league in scoring since Big Shaq way back in the 2000 season.
He's perfect from the line this time. And Joel Embiid, last season, the first center to average over 30 a game since Moses Malone did it back in 1982, Grant.
Oh, B.A., talk about historic company. And how about this? Also the first ever international player to lead the NBA in scoring, too. I mean, he won't be the last with the way things are.
Well, if you're giving up that much height, the only thing that you can do as a defender is to foul him.
Philadelphia calls timeout. Philadelphia has gone 1-of-4 from deep. Harden against Gilgeous-Alexander. Pass to Melton. Back to Harden. To the left side wing. Here's Embiid. Outside for Harden. Launches a 3. Second chance effort. Got a hand on it. They've got numbers. Here's Pokuševski, checked by Tucker. Pass to Williams. From the high post. Oklahoma City gets it back. Goes back up. Excellent D there from Embiid.
Yeah, can't see why he missed that one there. The D's close, but looked like plenty of room.
Harden, the pass to Embiid. And Embiid throws it down.
The focus of the defense. I mean, James Harden was able to use that attention and turn it into a hoop for someone else.
Oklahoma City has gone 0-for-2 from outside. Things just don't seem to be clicking for them offensively.
Yeah, they really need to find a way to get back on track.
Pass to Holmgren. Back to Giddey. Outside, Williams. Pulls it from the top of the key, and it's Philadelphia with the rebound. Embiid's got rebound number 8 here already in the game.
He's giving his all, but you can't force yourself back on track.
Now here's Tucker. Looking at his stats, he's putting up about 7.5 per game. There's the 3, and it's Holmgren with a rebound. Oklahoma City trailing. Left side Giddey. Soft touch off the glass.
Not afraid to try his luck down there. Giddey on the interior.
Gilgeous-Alexander against Harden. Here's Tucker. Blocked!
It's been an ugly quarter for him. Trying to shoot his way out of it. Might be time to work on the playmaking skills.
And the Thunder making a change here. Šarić checked in. And the 76ers making a change here. And for the Thunder, they're shooting only 31% to get this game underway. Back to Giddey. Here's Holmgren. Embiid covers. Pass to Giddey. Here's Holmgren. For three. And it's Harden who pulls down the rebound.
He's not the guy that you want to give a wide open look from three-point range. They're lucky that that one doesn't cost them.
Šarić, the pass to Gilgeous-Alexander. Back to Giddey. Pass to Holmgren. And again, Oklahoma City, no good. Philadelphia has gone just 1 of 6 from downtown. Harden into the lane, drains it. Now he's 3 for 5.
This is a solid opening quarter right here. Very active and creating a lot of good opportunities for himself.
Harden's gotten 3 of his 5 to go tonight. Now Gilgeous-Alexander. Back to Giddey. Pass to Šarić. Fires the jumper from the corner and nails it.
Catch and shoot opportunity for Dario, and he doesn't waste it.
Now Maxey. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Harris with it. And Brent, for those star-laden teams, this has to be a difficult time of year to stay completely focused.
Well, those teams have a bigger goal in mind, DA, all the time. And there is no doubt, they always think health first, getting proper rest, and making sure they're playing their best basketball come playoff time.
Now here's Gilgeous-Alexander. You know, his stats have been solid, averaging around 18.5 points a game. And it goes! As the official calls the foul, count it, and he'll shoot one more at the line. All right, a look at how the points have been generated so far. A scoring breakdown for the 76ers.
They've done a great job facilitating shooters. Their early game has seen a lot of hot passes and has kept the defense guessing as well.
Well, a lot of the players are doing a good job as well of scanning the interior part of the paint. All those inside looks, those are paying off.
That one drops. He ties it up.
Watching SGA run this offense, he's so patient and he reads the defense exceptionally well.
Time called here. The 76ers decide to talk it over. Yeah, Gilgeous-Alexander really plays at his pace, Grant.
You know, B.A., he's one of those guys the defense just can't speed up. And every move is purposeful. No wasted motion. He methodically breaks you down.
Dort, he's checked in for Gilgeous-Alexander. Philadelphia shooting only 31% to get this game underway. Outside Maxey. Milton comes up empty down low. Oklahoma City has gone 0-for-3 from downtown. Giddey's got space. And that one's on target from the wing. Giddey's gotten his second bucket on the night.
Impressive decision there as Giddey just shot that one with no hesitation.
A nice shot by Milton.
And you like the balance here. Not just falling in love with the three ball.
Outside Giddey. Pass to Šarić. It's hauled in by the Sixers. They're moving on after the tough loss at the hands of the Pelicans.
Yeah, it was really just the failure to convert shots on a consistent basis. That's going to cost you games, believe me.
Well, the defense against them had a little something to do with it, but you still got to go out there. You got to find a way to get good looks. You got to keep working the system. And quite frankly, they just couldn't do that.
In his rookie season, Grant, Giddey opened up a lot of eyes, certainly with his playmaking, but also with his rebounding.
Oh, B.A., he averaged almost 8 boards a game, playing around 30 minutes a night. His toughness and willingness to mix it up inside have been a welcome addition to this team.
Two. That free throw good from Giddey.
And it did not take long for Josh Giddey to find a place in this league as a taller point guard with incredible vision. This guy does a little bit of everything on the floor.
Both free throws good from Giddey. As for Giddey's quick start at the NBA, he recorded his first triple-double at age 19, Brent.
Yeah, pretty remarkable, B.A. The youngest player ever to get a triple-double in this league. And this is the kind of guy who just makes passes that other players don't even see or even think about. So his instincts are off the chart.
Now here's Giddey. He's got six. Pure from three-point range.
Pull-ups are not easy shots to sink, but Giddey with good balance that time.
Maxey passes to Harris. And the foul is called. He missed it, so he's got a couple of free throws coming his way. And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. The hustle stats for the Thunder.
They've been pretty intimidating on the defensive end, knocking away shootings, containing shooters, and making it tough to find looks.
Well, they've done a great job tonight of getting out in transition, so that focus on fast break will add to your total in a hurry.
And he makes a first.
Yeah, and despite being the youngest team in the league, the Thunder have been solid defensively the last couple years. A great sign going forward for this franchise.
Joe's checked in for Giddey. And Harris drops them both. And looking at this Oklahoma City roster, what makes them so good on D?
Well, they have loads of length. The Thunder have made a point to draft players with huge wingspans, making things difficult for opponents scoring-wise.
Here's Joe. Dort outside. Pass to Joe. Now here's Šarić. Guarded closely. That one misses. He's one for three. The Sixers trailing. 1:16 left now in the first quarter. Here's Maxey. And two free throws coming up as the whistle blows. He barely missed that one.
And the improvement of Tyrese Maxey's three-point shot from his first season to second year, just unprecedented. He improved by over 12% with a huge increase in attempts as well.
Free throws good from Maxey. And for a player with the speed and quickness of Maxey, Grant, leveling up that three-point shot changes everything for him.
Oh, so true, B.A. It becomes pick your poison with him. And it put him in a conversation last year for most improved player.
Both free throws good from Maxey.
Making shots at the line. You need a good routine, and he certainly has one.
Dort outside. Pass to Joe. 1 minute left to play in the first quarter. Here's Mann. And the first shot of the night for him. Missing. Philadelphia shooting an unremarkable 30% in the first. To the paint. Back to Maxey. From about 16, the shot comes out. So Oklahoma City will take it the other way. Shot is up. The shot by Dort, no good. And Philadelphia has possession. They trail by one. That's good. His first made shot in three attempts.
Just what they wanted from that possession. A quality look in tight.
Here's Mann. 14 points for him, last game against Charlotte. Pass to Šarić. Count that bucket. and the Thunder lead by one.
Well, Šarić on the inside has really good quality footwork.
And here's Harris outside. Oh, he got it up in time, but it wouldn't fall for him. And so it's Josh Giddey making highlights for the Oklahoma City Thunder. On the glass, he was an absolute tyrant, just owning the boards. More 2K action in just a moment. Let's get you back to the action on the floor as the New Year's Eve festivities continue. And what do you guys think about the Thunder here in this one?
Well, you have to credit their effort on the defensive end. It set the tone for this contest.
Yeah, defense has been infectious here as everybody stepping up aggressively on that end.
Philadelphia shooting an unimpressive 30% in this game so far. So, on the floor for Philadelphia to kick off the second quarter. Up front, it's Tucker at the four, next to Embiid in the middle. James Harden out there with DeAnthony Melton, and it's House in at the small forward position.
Wow! Always fun to see point guards who can elevate above the rim like that.
Oh, a strong mindset and even stronger finish.
Well, just seeking out weaknesses in the defense and then exploiting it.
And it's the Thunder with the ball. The Sixers getting their last shot to go. Williams passes to Gilgeous Alexander. That shot is off. Oh, excellent D there from Harden. The Sixers leading. The layup off target. The Thunder shooting only 36% so far in this game. Here's Pokuševski. And it's House with the rebound. And we played through the first minute here in the second. To the middle. Here's Tucker. Good setup. Led him to the rack perfectly for the layup.
P.J. Tucker, just one of those guys at his size that always looms larger on the floor. He is comfortable on the inside and finishing.
Trying to find a spark here.
Yes, indeed. A rough stretch offensively. They could really use a basket.
Holmgren. Joel Embiid with the board. Embiid's got 11 rebounds in the game. Harden, the pass to Embiid. Here's House. Outside Tucker. Pass to Embiid. Oh, he got it with a pump fake, but he couldn't finish. For Oklahoma City, they've got none of their first three shots to fall so far in the second.
And I think Shai Gilgeous-Alexander knows that this is an assist play in the making. Finds the open man.
Melton outside. Now Embiid. Melton up top. Wide open. That one a tad offline, but it drops in for him. Melton's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Such a critical part of how their offense is going to flow. Things are only working when he seems to be on the floor.
Pass to Joe. Inside. Here's Holmgren. Embiid covers. And he was camped in the lane there. He gets a 3 second call. Giddey's checked in for Oklahoma City. The 76ers have gone 3 of 5 since the beginning of the second. Melton passes to Harden. Down low. That's good. From Embiid on the assist by Harden. Embiid's got 6 points.
That's 3 buckets in a row off assist.
The Thunder have gotten only 1 of 4 shots to go in. Pass to Gilgeous Alexander. And about 3 minutes played now in the second quarter. Outside, Williams. 6 on the shot clock. And the replay of that slashing drive to the hoop, courtesy of Mobile One.
And I love the way he played downhill on that drive. Love the attack mentality in a close game.
And here's Harden. He has 7. Now here's Melton. Embiid passes to Tucker. No good with the triple.
Teammates right now covering up for the type of off performance he's having. In terms of scoring, this has not been his best night.
Gives us a chance to catch up with Allie LaForce.
Thanks, Brian. James Harden, with plenty of confidence, said, "Not to brag or anything, but I'm really good at this game. I'm unselfish. I play the right way. I don't try to do anything I can't do or that doesn't benefit our team. And that mindset keeps me in a good place." BA?
Very self-assured, Allie. Thank you. Now here's Giddey. He's got 11. Pass to Williams. Here's Pokuševski. Over Tucker. And it's Oklahoma City scoring again.
And the coaches want him to take that kind of shot. You can see why.
To the inside. And he'll draw the foul. He'll head to the line for 2. Well, you know it takes courage to draw charges. Guys get trucked all the time, and they still call a blocking foul. You think more of those should be no calls, Grant?
You know, B.A., courage is the right word. If you're willing to step in there and sacrifice your body for the sake of the team, you know what? If you don't give them a charge, I'd prefer the no call. I like that idea.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 seconds.
The free throw drops for Embiid.
A fun-loving player on and off the court, Embiid continues to get better. One of the league's top big men.
And Embiid drops them both.
Well, we're starting to see the pieces fall into place in OKC. Their number 2 overall pick, Chet Holmgren, showing tremendous promise. And the chemistry he's developing with Josh Giddey and SGA makes them very, very intriguing.
Now, here's Williams. What, no scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. And they recover it. They get the rebound. Tries yet again. Here's Holmgren. It's good. And he drew contact on the shot, so he will go to the line. A 3-point play opportunity.
You know, in the past several seasons, there's been one constant with the 76ers. They're going to be among the best defensive teams in the league.
Now here's Harden. He's got 7. Oh, it's blocked by Gilgeous-Alexander.
Nice job, SGA, coming in and using that long, athletic wingspan.
Snatched up.
Here's Pokuševski.
Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
And that really has to lift his teammates' spirits right now.
I'll tell you, Grant, these second-chance buckets could be what this game comes down to.
Well, especially in a close game, every possession matters.
The Sixers' identity really does center around their defense.
It's so true, B.A., and they've done a great job playing to their strengths. That's the key for any contending team. Maximize your players' talents. Philly has done that as well as anybody.
Now here's Melton. He's coming off a 10-point game against the Pelicans in New Orleans. Inside, Embiid. And the rebound goes to the Thunder. Pokuševski's got his 7th rebound here tonight. Here's Williams. Oh, not wasting any time and taking the shot and hitting it. And the Thunder lead by 1.
They just look so overwhelmed inside. Yeah, that's why they continue to get attacked.
Pass to House.
Yes, sir! Oh, that's what you tune in for right there.
Wow. And the dunk to finish it off. A beauty.
Everyone knows Harden is a talented passer. He can really rack up those assists.
Oklahoma City has gone 0-for-2 from outside in the second quarter. Giddy against Melton. To the middle. Here's Williams. Tries again. And it's Philadelphia with the rebound. House has got 4 rebounds in the game. Harden against Gilgeous Alexander. Here's Embiid. And Embiid throws it down. Great game for him. Double-double now.
The control and focus from Embiid. Able to absorb hits from the defense and still finish.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. And Harden, a former league MVP, 3-time scoring champ. Grant, the only thing he's missing is a title.
Yeah, B.A., I mean, it would only help cement his legacy. For years, he'd carry his team only to run out of gas in the playoffs. But postseason success counts for a lot when it's all said and done.
Šarić checks in for Oklahoma City. Mann comes in for Pokuševski. And a new group getting ready for the Sixers. Tobias Harris checked in for Joel Embiid. Niang comes in for Tucker. Milton's checked in for James Harden. And it's Maxey in for Melton.
And Šarić, just one of those European players that comes over with the fundamentals. Beautiful play there.
Here's Maxey, following the bucket by the Thunder. Outside Milton, down low. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair. The Thunder have really struggled the last couple of years.
Yeah, remember back when they had Durant, Harden, and Westbrook? Oh, quite a lineup. Not that they need 3 superstars again, but they need some sort of boost.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 seconds.
First one falls for him.
0 wasted trips. They're doing their job at the line.
A different look for Oklahoma City. Williams comes in for Williams, and it's Dort in for Giddy. And Harris drops them both.
I feel like Tobias Harris's confidence has grown over the past couple seasons, especially on the offensive end. Very capable of taking advantage of smaller defenders.
I mean, they've been relentless. Just keep getting shots at the rim.
Maxey passes to Milton. Back to Maxey. Out to the right wing. Here's House. And Gilgeous Alexander with a block. And so the ball out of bounds. Gilgeous Alexander tucks it last. Here's Niang. Here's House. Šarić covers. Shot clock at 2. Milton.
If you get Dort in a wrestling match, he's going to win. He's playing physical D now.
This has been a close game in a lot of ways, but they do have an edge on the boards.
And the chess match continues.
7 lead changes already, and we're still in the first half.
Outside Maxey. To the left wing. The 3 is up. It's hauled in by Šarić.
And he probably thought he was going to bury that one.
His man. 3-pointer off the mark. Philadelphia has gone just 1-of-5 so far this quarter from 3. Here's Harris. It's not going to go for him. Šarić with some nice D. Pass to Mann. And here's Dort. Takes it inside. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So 2 free throws for him coming up. It goes on Shake Milton.
Dort not afraid to use his size and to play with that kind of physicality.
And when Dort's out there, Grant, he really gives this team a physical presence.
Oh, I like this guy, B.A. I mean, very strong, very aggressive at both ends. He makes a lot of hustle plays. Seems like every successful team has 1 or 2 of those guys like him.
That's good from Dort.
Wiggins Dort continues to find ways to impress you and expand his offensive game. But he knows he's coming to the league as a defender, and he takes a tremendous amount of pride in it.
Williams has checked in for Oklahoma City. That one's no good. The Sixers trailing. Here we go. The Sixers on the break.
And that was just moving the ball quickly. And he's rewarded at the end with a high percentage look.
Yeah, the defense trying to do their best to slow him down. But when he gets room like that, you got to look out.
And for Oklahoma City, they're shooting 45% here in the second. Pass to Gilgeous Alexander. Outside, Williams. Back to Gilgeous Alexander. Six to shoot. And again, Oklahoma City, no good. Well, the 76ers shooting 42% in the second quarter. Here's House. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against the Pelicans in New Orleans. Wow, 8 lead changes in the first half. Unbelievable.
Yeah, both sides digging in for what looks like a war.
Here's Mann. Dort outside. Pass to Gilgeous Alexander. Now Williams. Pounded by Harris. Here's Mann. And it's all from three-point range.
And the defense got away with one there. I mean, that's the shot he typically makes.
Got a piece of it. And stolen by Williams. Finished off the break. And the Thunder lead by one.
Two teammates connecting right there. Slick feed.
The kick out to Milton. The three ball. Gets it to go. Makes him 2 for 5.
Can't give those openings defensively. He'll just keep exploiting them.
Oklahoma City has gone just 1 of 5 so far this quarter from three. Outside Gilgeous Alexander. Williams passes to Gilgeous Alexander. Clock at 6. The 3. Rebound by the 76ers.
Just cannot get anything to go. If there's going to be a way to get out of this hole, I don't think he'll be the one to do it.
Milton, no good. Milton's gone just 2 of 6 shooting, 33%. Outside for Gilgeous Alexander. On the wing man. Outside Gilgeous Alexander. Over Milton. Kept alive. Great positioning on the putback.
He really gets in perfect position for the follow. Just a terrific read.
Maxey passes to Milton. Back to Maxey. 26 seconds left in the first half of this one. The rebound by Mann. The Thunder shooting 40% so far in this one. Pass to Dort. Gilgeous Alexander on the wing. Here's the teardrop, and it's good for 2. Gilgeous Alexander's got 9.
Gilgeous Alexander comes at you in a lot of ways. There's floaters and pull-ups and drives. Pretty gifted offensive player.
Everyone in the building saw the obvious contact.
And he knocks down the first one. So both teams making some changes here. Both shots good from the stripe. So the clock runs out with the score tied going into the half. All right, Allie's ready to go. She's courtside. Hey, Allie.
76ers.
Joel, the reserves have been awesome so far. What are you seeing from them?
on the bench has helped us a lot. They've come in, they scored the ball, they've got a stop, so we're going to need them to keep it going.
Helps to have backup. Good luck in the second half.
Okay, Ali, appreciate it. And folks, we'll be back after halftime to begin the third quarter.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, everybody. Boy, what a crowd joining us here for our halftime report. I'm Ernie Johnson alongside Kenny the Jet Smith and the Diesel, Shaquille O'Neal. A competitive matchup for Oklahoma City in the first quarter. Their biggest lead in the first, 5 points. They couldn't hold on to the slim lead they had at the start of the second quarter and headed into the locker room with the game all knotted up. Shaq, your thoughts on the Thunder?
Ernie, they're taking way too many threes. The offense has no rhythm. They need to go back to the drawing board. Maybe try to get a little bit more transition, more off the pick and roll. Anything other than shooting that three. It's not going.
And Kenny, your take on Philadelphia.
The differential is the free throw attempt. And that's one of the big stories in this game tonight. They were being so aggressive and so smart that all they could do on the defensive end was foul.
And that's all we have for now. Tell the folks goodbye, Shaq. Tell the folks goodbye,
goodbye.
Kenny. Goodbye. Go to Kevin Harlan.
And we've got second half action for you. Thus far, a pretty evenly contested game. One guy who's been getting it done is Josh Giddey.
I like how they control the tempo and play to his strengths.
Yeah, this is showing that they're not going to play at anybody else's pace but their own.
Tandem at the one and the two, it's Giddey and Gilgeous-Alexander. Alexei Pokuševski is out there with Holmgren. And it's Williams in at the three. That's the lineup out there for the Thunder. Here's House. Pass to Embiid. Five on the clock. And Embiid gets the double team. Here's House. The shot misses. Ooh, some solid defense from Gilgeous-Alexander. Gilgeous-Alexander on the wing. Now Williams. Outside Gilgeous-Alexander. Back to Williams. Pass to Pokuševski. Puts up a three. The rebound by Embiid. Embiid's got rebound number 12 now. Tenacity on the glass. And Harden with the slam.
Oh, you cannot allow Harden this type of positioning because he's going to dunk all over you when you do.
And a minute played as the second half gets going. Outside Gilgeous-Alexander. Here's Pokuševski. Checked by Tucker. And it's blocked by Embiid. Here's House. Outside Harden. Outside Tucker. Pass to House. Now here's Embiid. Embiid drawing the double team. And stolen by Williams. Outside Giddey. To the paint. Ooh, poked away.
Not been an easy start. Three straight misses here on these possessions.
And Melton, here we go. Here's House. From outside, off the mark.
Well, even though he misses that one, the defense has got to talk about that. And that's a bad miscue. And you can't give up looks like that all game long.
And what a phenomenal replay of that impressive rejection.
Oh, terrific defensive intensity right there. Getting stops like that is crucial for them right now.
The Thunder have gone 0 for 3 to start the second half. Pass to Holmgren. Williams on the wing. The baseline J is on the way.
Not sure they realize it's not halftime anymore. Four attempts, and they're still looking for their first bucket.
Outside Harden. Fires the three. Drops in the three. Harden's got 5 points now this quarter.
That's been typical of their performance today. They're sharing the ball and creating good shots.
Boy, they need something to go to regain some confidence.
No question. Way too many empty possessions for them.
And let's swing it over to the sideline and hear from Allie.
Brian, Sixers head coach Doc Rivers earned the nickname Doc back in college for wearing a t-shirt with Julius Erving on it. In the NBA, he said, quote, "The first game I started was against the Sixers. I went over and said, Dr. J, how are you? And he said, Doc, how are you? I said, no, I'm Glenn. But he said, no, you're Doc. And that made me feel like $1 million. Guys.
All right, thanks, Allie.
And what's working here? Each guy is willing to make the next pass.
Clock keeps going. 3 minutes into the second half now. Time called here. The Thunder decide to talk it over.
Failing to find a rhythm offensively. Something that needs to change and change soon.
Yeah, they're like a four-day-old soda right now, just flat. They're missing shots left and right and just not playing their best.
Pass to Pokuševski. Williams with it. Looking at his stats, he's putting up about 7.5 per game. Back to Giddey. Shot clock at 6. From deep, Holmgren. They get it back. Now Philadelphia with it. They've gone on an 8-0 run. Here's House. Down low, Tucker. He drains it. Made half his shots. He's 5-for-10 now.
I don't think this is a conditioning issue, but they look like they've lost their legs here in the second half.
Second half here, and we're just over 3.5 minutes into it.
I'll tell you what, a lot can be said about the contract Harden took to stay in Philly. He took less than what he commanded to help the team sign depth and rotation players. A very big gesture from Harden, showing just how much he wants to win in Philly.
Hate to say it, but if they're still trailing at the final buzzer, a lot of this is going to be felt by him. His shooting tonight has just been atrocious.
Embiid controls the rebound and the putback.
A sequence you might expect from Embiid, an elite rebounder, and the man knows how to finish.
And the Thunder call time here. Well, Grant, we're seeing players extend their careers. Often diet plays a big role. How important was that in your day, and how important do you think that is now?
It's so important. The food you put into your body, the rest, the recovery, all of that plays a role in extending your career and having great longevity along the way.
Here's Holmgren. He's got 5. Shoots over Embiid. And again, Oklahoma City, no good.
They are really struggling to stop this run.
Frustration seems to be mounting here, and you can see not just in their faces, but right now in their quick and hurried shot selection.
And let's take a moment to get your take, guys, on the scoring so far for the 76ers.
I mean, they've played some beautiful basketball all game. The passing has been impressive, and it's opened up things with their ball movement.
Well, the three-point shot has been absolutely huge for them this entire game. And let's be honest, you have to knock down threes to win games these days.
The first one falls. And that one goes in. 2 from the line that time. Oklahoma City has gotten nothing to fall from outside in this third quarter. Pass to Pokuševski. To the middle. Here's Holmgren. Their offense stone cold. Another miss there. Here's House. Williams defending. Now here's Embiid. He's got 12. From deep, Melton. Here's the second effort. Oh, a clear foul there on the missed shot. So he'll get a pair at the line.
And the moment Embiid gets the ball anywhere near the hoop, it's over. Too strong to stop without fouling.
The free throw drops for Embiid. Good on both.
And really strong at the line since the break.
Boy, they'd love if anyone could get a bucket.
Yeah, their offense has been grinding to a halt.
Giddy passes to Williams. Tipped away. Stolen by Harden. To the inside. And Tucker gets it to go. Tucker's got 7 points here in the quarter.
Oh, I see the clock. It's rewinding as P.J. Tucker is getting it going. This is a throwback.
Now a timeout call by Oklahoma City. It wasn't an easy road to the NBA for P.J. Tucker. Brett, he spent most of his early career in Europe.
Yeah, those first 5 years, he never gave up on the dream to get back stateside and play in the league. So working hard on his game, understanding his game, and he's been such a great player for this past decade with a ring to show for it.
Now here's Williams. And again, Oklahoma City, no good.
They've had a slight leg up on the boards and a big leg up on the scoreboard.
Giddy against Melton. Inside. And Tucker gets it to go. Tucker's got 9 points here in the second half.
And force feeding the ball inside. I mean, no reason to go away from what's working.
Outside Giddy. Pass to Pokuševski. Down low. They need this. And it's laid up and in by Williams. Williams has got his third basket on the night right there.
And Poku with the processing speed just got rid of that one quick.
And we just had to see that mobile one drive one more time. Great stuff.
Yeah, taking the onus on himself to make something happen. Got it into the teeth of the defense and made them pay.
Melton against Williams. Embiid. Count it. Embiid's got 16 points now.
You know Embiid loves to produce like this, and you can tell it's firing up the team as well.
Oklahoma City has got nothing to fall from outside in this third quarter. Outside, Gilgeous Alexander. Pass to Williams. Back to Gilgeous Alexander. Down to 5 on the shot clock. And the ball out of play. The Sixers will have it. The Thunder making a switch here. Mann's checked in. And Philadelphia also making a switch. Harris has checked in. Now the 76ers with it. This run now at 22-2. Now Melton. Averaging around 6 a game. Outside Tucker fires the three. The Thunder with the rebound. A shot from the high post. And Williams gets the bucket on the assist from Holmgren. Holmgren's got his third assist of the night. And here's Harden. He's got 12. Harris left side. Lets it go from deep. The putback. It's good on the putback. Embiid's got 8 points in the quarter.
And guys, the way this defense is getting manhandled down low, you have to wonder if they're at 100% right now.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander, and it's blocked by Embiid.
We see it time and time again. Embiid relishes his role as an intimidator.
Take Take a break. Two shots.
The free throw drops for Williams. And some changes here for the 76ers. Montrezl Harrell, he's checked in for Tucker. And it's Tyrese Maxey in for James Harden. That one misses, so he goes 1 for 2.
Maybe there are ways to contribute that don't involve shooting the basketball. That's the best way that maybe he can help them out in trying to win this game.
Now here's Embiid. 18 points for him over Williams. Again, the Sixers score.
Could come down to selection. Bad shots in the first half. Here in the second, using his head, finding some more efficient opportunities to score.
Oklahoma City has got nothing to fall from outside in this third quarter. Pass to Joe. Williams with it. Dort outside. Shot clock at 5. Williams finds Dort. The Thunder with another miss.
And they're plus 5 on the boards after that rebound.
Here's Maxey. That one is off. So Oklahoma City will take it the other way. And that's a foul called on Montrezl Harrell. That's his first foul. And for the Thunder, they're shooting just 35% from the floor. And there's the foul. It's on Joel Embiid. That's foul number 2 for him. ...76ers on D. A 21-point lead, the biggest in the game. Williams from long range knocks down the triple. Williams has got 8 points here in the quarter.
I mean, could we say he was playing possum a bit there in the first half? Because he seems to be a different guy out there, way more assertive.
Pass to Harrell. To the middle. Here's Melton. It's tipped!
And Dort making his impact, and that's the end we expected from defensively.
And he makes it.
They found strong offensive footing in the open court.
They've done very, very well in transition. The problems have come in other areas, which is why they're trailing.
Now here's Maxey. He has 6. Harrell with it. Poke loose and stolen by Williams. Here's Mann. As far as his production, he's averaging about 8 points per game. From 9 feet. And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Opportunity for a 3-point play here.
Oh, unreal play to take on the contact and get it to go.
Holmgren, he's checked in for Williams.
One shot.
...1:56 left in the third. Outside Maxey. Pass to Embiid. Here's Harrell. From downtown. And Embiid is good for 3. Embiid's got 13 points in this quarter.
He's been incredible in this half. Anytime he pulls up from outside, you think that's Bottoms.
Here's Joe. Pounded by Harris. Here's Mann. The rebound by Maxey.
Nice rebound. Trying to match the other team's intensity right now.
Oh, there's the alley. Up high and down it goes on the lob.
Some heads up ball there from Dort.
Outside Maxey. Not watching the line there. That'll be a backcourt violation. Milton's checked in for Melton. ...1 minute left in the third quarter. Holmgren. misses from close range.
He's been off the mark, and that hasn't helped them chip away at the lead. It's been a theme here this quarter.
Pass to Embiid. Harris on the wing. The Sixers with another miss.
I know he's on a cold streak, but he can't let that get in his head.
Especially if you're a player that doesn't get a lot of shot attempts. But otherwise, the mindset is, I just got to get the next one to go. And you don't want to put that much pressure on yourself.
Maxey with it. He has six. Pass to Embiid. Back to Maxey. 4-3. The rebound by Mann. Oklahoma City's going just 1-5 from three-point range here in the third quarter. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
Well, Dort has that great compact fire hydrant type of build, and he'll take that kind of contact.
Shooting two.
And the first one at the line is good. And Dort hits them both. There's 14 seconds left in the third. Outside Maxey. Embiid finds Harris. Tries to break his ice. And it was still over the rim. Offensive basket interference. And so it's the Philadelphia 76ers ending the quarter up 10. Just pounding the painted area. That's helped him build an advantage. We'll be right back after this word. And a moment now as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
You know, I'm kind of stoked that this was a choice because I love this pass. A remarkable find. He put his court vision on full display.
Well, a great job with the eyes. And what separates great playmakers, as we know, is peripheral vision.
With three quarters behind us, let's see what this fourth period holds in store. On the court for Philadelphia to start the fourth. Maxey and Harden make up the backcourt. Daniel House out there with P.J. Tucker. And it's Harris in at the five. Back to Dort. And there's a whistle. He'll head to the line to shoot two. James Harden picks one up.
Shooting two.
The first free throw is good. Fokoshevsky's checked in for Oklahoma City. And Dort hits them both. And here are the Sixers now. Their biggest lead of the game was 21. They'll be playing host to New Orleans for their next one. That'll be the first of three games played at home. Harris passes to Tucker. And here's Harden. Dort defending. Harden misses.
He didn't make them pay for that weak defense, but
They just can't rely on him to miss those kind of shots.
And the Thunder making a change here. Giddey's checked in. Oklahoma City trailing. Pass to Gilgeous-Alexander. Here's Pokuševski. The floater, and it's House with the rebound. House has got double-digit rebounds now in the game. Harden, the pass to Maxey. Back to Harden. Offensive rebound. The steal. Dort, the pass to Giddey. Now here's Dort. Shoots. And that one off the back of the rim and in.
Man, if this offense can get Lugans Dort to become a reliable option, it's going to open some stuff up.
Here's Harden. He can't get that one to fall. And for the Thunder, they're shooting around 39%. They'd like to get that higher. Holmgren. And he banks in the layup.
Smart play call to get him something at the rim.
Well, taking advantage of that opportunity, it does not get any more high percentage than that one.
Now here's Tucker. Oh, plenty of contact on that shot. Officials call the foul, and he'll take two free throws now.
And right now, if you're the defense, you've got to be careful. Harden excels at finding ways to get to the free throw line.
And he drops a first.
A nightly triple-double threat. Harden's level of creativity and incredible confidence makes him lethal.
It's both from the stripe. We're about 2 minutes into the fourth here. Dort outside. Outside, Gilgeous-Alexander. Oh, a beautiful reverse layup.
Gilgeous-Alexander creative and tricky on that play.
The 76ers have gone 0 for 3 in this fourth. Not good. Pass to House. For three, Maxey knocks down the long J. And the 76ers lead by 7.
This is what it's been since halftime. Remarkable results from downtown.
Yeah, pretty infectious right here. Guys in good spirits and percentages from downtown on the rise in the second half.
Now here's Dort. Shoots over Harden. And they get it back.
Yeah, maybe a little luck, maybe a little bit of heart. Both of those at play here. He's getting every offensive rebound.
And that was the right decision. When you're in need of a bucket, you go to your most trusted guys.
Yeah, whether it's teammates or the coaching staff, hopefully a combination of both. But when it gets close, he's getting the ball.
And Philadelphia calls time here.
And I think Shai Gilgeous-Alexander, just another one in that long line of Kentucky Wildcats coming into the NBA that has carved out a pretty nice career so far in the league.
Let's check in with our reporter, Allie LaForce.
Well, over the break, I listened in on Doc Rivers' huddle. He likes what he's seeing, but he cautioned his players, we are not far enough ahead to assume anything. Momentum can shift in a heartbeat. We have to be diligent, and we have to be smart.
Okay, good stuff. Thank you, Allie. From deep, Giddey. And that comes off the assist by Gilgeous-Alexander. Gilgeous-Alexander's got 5 assists tonight. The 76ers have gotten only 1 of 5 to fall here in the fourth. It has been fantastic watching Gilgeous-Alexander continue to improve.
And I love B.A. also, along with his improvement, what we've seen in terms of his leadership and responsibility to this team. He shows a very strong work ethic. And this is why a lot of people are still excited about his growth and progress.
His nimbleness makes him a unique threat at the rim.
And no lack of aggression on that move. Good for the 2K drive.
Yeah, B.A., I mean, that's such a big play here in a close game like this one. Great concentration from him.
Pass to Gilgeous Alexander. Out to the right wing. Here's Holmgren. Pounded by Harris. Six to shoot. Dort against Harden. Lets it go from the wing. Philadelphia grabs the miss. House has got 11 rebounds in the game. To the inside. And the layup is good after a nice lead pass. And now a six-point Philadelphia lead. For Oklahoma City, they've gone 5 of 8 from the field so far in the fourth. Pass to Giddey. Dort with it. Outside Gilgeous Alexander. Here's Holmgren. Pounded by Harris. Dort outside. And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take two from the free throw line.
I don't mind that. I mean, they met him at the rim and temporarily prevented the points.
Shooting two.
That's good from Dort. And Dort hits them both. Philadelphia's gone 1 of 2 from deep in this quarter. To the paint. Here's Harris. He's off on that one. So Oklahoma City will take it the other way.
And a struggle for him tonight, but if they can make this lead hold up, he can just chalk this up as one of those nights.
Williams has checked in for Dort. The 76ers also with a sub. Melton's checked in. Oklahoma City trailing. Pass to Williams. Back to Giddey. Harden against Gilgeous Alexander. Oh, stolen by Harden. Harris right side. Outside for Harden. Good work defensively by Gilgeous Alexander. For Oklahoma City, they've gone 5 of 8 from the field so far in the fourth. Pass to Giddey. Hey, yo, right here. On the way. Outside, Williams. Here's Pokuševski. Takes a three. And it's Philadelphia with the rebound. House has got a rebound number 12 now. Tenacity on the glass. And here's Melton. Over Williams. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket is good, and he'll go to the line.
Man, what focus. I mean, the hoop and the harm. Incredible.
Embiid, he's checked in for the Sixers. And the Thunder shooting a terrific 56% so far in the fourth quarter. Back to Gilgeous Alexander. Pass to Pokuševski. Now Williams. And another shot. Again, no good by Oklahoma City.
The defense better tighten up on the mid-range. They're much, much tighter. You expect him to make every single one of those.
Knocked loose. Ooh, it's stolen by Gilgeous Alexander. They've got numbers.
It's a little too early to be over the limit. They need to keep a close eye on their foul situation. An unusual skill set for his size. Holmgren can initiate offense from every level on the floor. I mean, his versatility is unbelievable.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
That free throw, no good. You expect seven-footers to operate off-ball. But Holmgren is just as good with the ball in his hands, Grant.
Yes, he is, B.A. I mean, we've seen him go coast-to-coast in the open floor, take his defender off the dribble, and get to the rim. And if you sag off him, well, he can just rise up and fire.
Grant, it's amazing how Holmgren transforms your defense when he's on the floor.
Yeah, B.A., I mean, he really makes up for a lack of strength with length and tremendous timing. He has the lateral footwork to defend 1-5 as well. And, of course, he can block shots from any spot on the floor.
And a fast break now for the Thunder. And that one's good. Gilgeous Alexander.
Gilgeous Alexander, fantastic concentration.
The Sixers leading. Now here's Harden. Outside Tucker. Pass to Embiid. Shoots over Holmgren with the tip. Oh, he hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points. Tucker's got 11 in the second half.
They have hit the boards hard this half. Those second chance points are mounting up.
Gilgeous Alexander with the ball. Defended by Harden. Here's Holmgren. Outside, Williams. Just five to shoot. Unloads. And it's Holmgren missing. Philadelphia's gone 1-for-3 in the fourth quarter from range. Harden. And Gilgeous Alexander with a block. And so it looks like it'll be Philadelphia ball. On the wing, Harden. Gilgeous Alexander defending. Beyond the arc. And it's Harden. That time on the assist from Embiid. Harden's got 5 points now this quarter.
Well, he just nailed his second three of the half, guys. I'd be very aware of that if I were the defense right now.
For Oklahoma City, they've gotten 6 of their 13 shots to go. Pass to Holmgren. The kick out to Williams. The rebound by Embiid.
He's trying to force his way into a rhythm, but that's not helping the team.
Melton against Williams. And there's the call. It's going to be an illegal screen.
You can get away with one once in a while, but it looked like he wasn't completely set on that pick.
Yeah, a quick little lean like that is going to get the ref's attention. Foul call.
And it's Gilgeous Alexander on the drive.
Gilgeous Alexander coming at you in a lot of ways right now, so a thorn in the defense's side.
Shoot two.
That free throw good from Gilgeous Alexander.
You know, Shai Gilgeous Alexander has so many of the qualities that you want in a leader. He fights, he's energetic, he's a team first guy, and he just looks for ways to get his guys fired up.
Both free throws good from Gilgeous Alexander. Philadelphia has gone 2-of-4 from the perimeter here in the fourth quarter. Melton against Giddey. Melton passes to Embiid. Oh, nice fake, but the layup's off the mark. And for the Thunder, they're shooting about 43% since the fourth quarter began. Blocked by Embiid. Here's House. Williams defending. Pass to Tucker. He's got it. His ninth make out of 15 tries.
He's got a lot to do with the position that they're in. A very smart offensive performance tonight from him.
Oklahoma City trailing. Oklahoma City calls timeout. Boy, you look at Joel Embiid. He's playing really well right now.
And they simply have no answer right now for what he's doing to them. He is making them pay.
And now let's take a look at the New Balance player of the game, DeAnthony Melton.
And he's really had a tremendous night from the field. He's shooting at a clip over 50%. I'll tell you what, that's the kind of efficiency that makes a coach rest well at night.
Boy, he'd been struggling a lot in the past few games. Good to see him bounce back with such a strong effort here tonight. Here's Holmgren. Outside, Gilgeous Alexander. A step back shot, and the shot's good. Gilgeous Alexander's got 8 here in this quarter.
Are you serious? I mean, he made the defender look silly right there. Just an epic move.
Pass to Embiid. Melton against Giddey. Now here's Melton. He's closely guarded. 5 to shoot. Here's Harden. And it's Holmgren with a rebound. Holmgren's got rebound number 10 tonight with that last one. From behind the arc, fires in the triple. And now just a 4-point 76ers lead.
And Poku making better and better decisions with the basketball.
Harden against Gilgeous Alexander. Pass to Embiid. Now Gilgeous Alexander. To the middle. Here's Pokuševski. That one's good. And so Gilgeous Alexander with the assist. Gilgeous Alexander's got 6 assists now in the game. Now here's Melton. There's 1:34 left in the fourth quarter. Right wing. 6 on the shot clock. Pass to Tucker. Fires for 3. Second shot opportunity, and the basket by Embiid. Embiid's got 15 points in just the second half.
These are the moments Embiid loves. Enjoys being the player for this team to take and make clutch shots.
And the bucket is good.
Gilgeous Alexander coming through big time.
Melton outside. Pass to Embiid. Here's Tucker. Oh, he drained it from downtown.
And P.J. Tucker ready for the big one.
There's 57 seconds left in the game. Gilgeous Alexander against Harden. And it's blocked by Embiid. Melton outside. Let's go with a 3. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City.
And this is exactly who you want taking that shot. He just missed it.
Gilgeous Alexander gonna celebrate that one.
Huge moment here.
You have to stay calm in these situations.
Pass to Embiid. To the wing, right side. Now here's Melton. Gilgeous Alexander defending. Offensive rebound. Embiid. Count it!
Really feels like they're in control. They've got a big lead with time dwindling.
Yeah, looking for a miracle worker out there is the opposing coaching staff. I don't know that they have one. This game seems to be well in hand.
And the Thunder call time here. They trail by 5. There's 18 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. All right, guys, what do you think?
Score quick, then foul. Then you have to hope for some missed free throws.
Yeah, this won't be easy, so a little bit of luck will go a long way for them to get back in.
And his fantastic performance from the last game has carried over to tonight.
Yeah, and the coach pretty smart for zoning in on him and giving him opportunities to stay with that confident play.
And so they choose to intentionally foul.
And a smart choice right there. I mean, you can't allow them to just drain the clock.
Good on the first, and that gives him a 4-point cushion.
And it's Harden at the line. This team wants him there. You better believe that.
Second one is good. Getting both at the line. And it's a 5-point game.
Ooh, I think that's a wrap. And I can tell you, you can't have more pressure-packed free throws than the ones that are going to seal the game. Can't talk enough about the subtleties and that setup right there. The assist, really the key to that entire sequence.
Yeah, and there's no question they have to foul. Now, I'm sure they would have preferred to avoid it.
First free throw is good, and that makes it a three-point lead. And he hits both free throws here, and it's a four-point ball game. There's 6 seconds left to play in the fourth quarter. From deep, and it's good. And that one brings them within one.
And Giddy with a little giddy up on that pass.
And they go to the intentional foul. Put him up two. So he goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's a three-point game.
Huge free throws, bumps the lead up to three, and now they simply have to guard against the three ball.
So a close game sees Philadelphia taking this one. And this was an emotional win for them, no doubt about it.
Just a fantastic accomplishment. You love how they just diffuse the energy in this arena.
Well, now a minute to check in with Allie LaForce. She's courtside. Hey, Allie.
Guys, thanks so much. PJ, congrats on the win. What do you think was the biggest factor for you guys tonight?
I think this is pretty good, this whole game. Everybody stuck to our principles. And more than anything, we just play hard. We play hard as crap tonight.
Keeping it simple. Thanks, PJ.
Allie, thank you as always. And that'll do it, folks. For Brent Berry, Allie LaForce, and Grant Hill, this is Brian Anderson thanking you for tuning in. We'll see you next time.